So, a few weeks ago, I saw this post on the Godot Engine website. My first reaction was, cool. But my second reaction was, where is the iOS version? And I saw this one line in the article. It read, the same tenets apply to other platforms supported by the Godot Engine, like iOS. And the implementation is left as an exercise to the reader. So I immediately thought to myself, challenge accepted. After a quick and very thorough search on the internet, which proved to me I was the only one to ever think of this brilliant idea, I jumped into the Godot contributors chat and asked around. As it turns out, there have been a few attempts and a couple of people were already working on an iPad version. After a lengthy discussion and lots of tweaking over a few days, we got a somewhat working engine deployed on the iPad. If you're interested in the code we ended up with, you can find a link in the description. But be warned, it will not work by itself without some manual tweaking. Keep watching to see how I got it to work. The first step to get the Godot engine to work on iOS is to compile it for ARM64 processors using sconce, which is the official build tool used by the Godot developers. This takes a very long time to compile and results in a static library file named something like this. I renamed it to libgodot.a and kept it somewhere safe because I will need it later. Next, I created an empty Godot project. It doesn't matter what the project is since I only need the exported skeleton. To export the project for iOS, I had to use my Apple developer account. I have seen other people who managed to do this with a free Apple ID, but I have a developer account, so that's what I used. I also needed to give the app a bundle ID. The rest of the warnings can be ignored. Then I replaced the libgodot.a file in the exported project with the one created earlier at the compilation step. This is only possible because the Godot engine is itself a Godot application. So by doing this, I am basically exporting the engine as if it was a game. Now, all I had to do was open up the project in Xcode, delete the PCK file, and deploy the app to my device. This works on both iPad and iPhone, though the screen on the iPhone is way too small to make it useful. Now, the question you are all probably thinking. Is this available on the App Store? And the answer is no. The app in its current status will never pass the app review process. This is for a couple of reasons. First, Godot makes use of sub-processes to run and play projects. While this is possible to do on Android operating systems, it is not possible on iOS. So the solution was to kill the application and run it again to switch between the different modes. This works, but unfortunately Apple does not allow you to just kill your application whenever you like. My solution to this was to create two different apps, one for the editor and one for the player. The idea here is that when you press the play button in the editor, the player app will be automatically launched. I have this already working, but we still have the project manager to take care of. This is also running in a separate process, and I thought that creating a third app just for that seems to be a little bit silly. The only solution I can think of right now is to diverge from the Godot code base in my own fork, but that would make long-term maintainability very difficult. What do you think? Do you have any ideas how to solve this issue? Is it even worth all the effort to release Godot to the App Store? If I'm really honest, there doesn't seem to be a big demand for it, and I have reached the point of diminishing returns. So, it is becoming more and more difficult to stay motivated to get this working. Let me know. Continue or abandon? Thanks for watching.